Hey YouTube, I'm Vic Rivers, and for Emma's 2018 tool making competition, I'll make a new chuck key for my Atlas lathe. I got this lathe for free, and the part of the deal was that I had to take a bunch of junk with it, and unfortunately in that junk there was no chuck key. So I've been using a quarter inch ratchet extension and a T-handle, and for the new chuck key that I'm going to make it out of a piece of 1-inch cold rolled. So stick around and watch.
I know cold rolled sucks for making tools, but it was pretty much all I could get a hold of. So I started out with cutting a short piece off of the stock, and then I faced it off before heading to the mill to cut the square on it. So here I'm just poking a hole through the middle of the stock, and that way I can attach it to a 1-2-3 block. I was trying to square up the V block that, or the 1-2-3 block that I attached it to, and then I ended up moving the 1-2-3 block down so it would push it parallel with the vise jaws. I zeroed my DRO on the center of the 1-inch stock, and then I worked off of so it would be 1/4 inch square and 3/4 inch end mill. So I was working 1/2 inch off center, or I worked down to 1/2 inch off center. During the climb milling, I just took small cuts.
So I obviously don't have a V block or collet block or anything like that, so that method worked pretty well.
So I started out cutting this taper with the compound set at 60 degrees. And I was using a drill motor to run the compound.
I think I'm going to reduce that taper so it's longer.
Just rechecking that the square was running true. I had to kind of tap it around to make it run true. Turned it down to 825. Had to do some filing to get that cleaned up. Just clean the mill scale off this side, turn down to 955. Parted it off so there would be a half inch of material from the top of the handle after facing it off. I almost did a bozo and put the radius on the end of this before putting the center in there. And this is just a piece of high-speed steel that I had on hand that had a radius ground in it. So working on the handle, put a center in it, I turned down just under 9 inches of material.
So I'm going to shoot for 565, I'm at 585. Thank you. thou and a half over. Let it cool and see what's at. Okay, well, what I've decided to do is I'm gonna drill and tap this here, and then put a hole through the handle and go that route. I was initially just gonna open this up and put weld in there, but I think this is more professional.
So cutting some new shim stock to put in my vise jaw so I don't mar up my finish. And I don't know what it is, but a pair of scissors really makes this lathe look small. So I'm drilling out 1764 so I can tap it 5/16-18. Clearance hole for 5/16-18 through the portion above the handle, and then diameter of the head. I can't remember what the size of the socketed cap screw was, but open it up with the drill and then with that boring bar, and then I opened up the clearance a little bit more. I had forgot to put this chamfer in when I had it in the chuck earlier. So just putting a through hole in the handle for 5/16-18. And finally just polishing it up in on a gray Scotch-Brite wheel on the bench grinder. This was on my rotary table ran by a drill gun, and I was hoping it would turn out a little bit better, but it's kind of a little bit out of frame. So with that, thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.